Well, today, the largest teachers union in the state hopes a judge sides with them to delay the start of in-person classes. Some counties have already started, but many in our area are on hold for another 2 weeks.
ABC Action News reporter Jasmine Stiles breaks down the changes that have happened since the emergency hearing last week.
Last Wednesday, a court sided with the state's attorneys and decided to transfer this case to a Leon County judge. After two recusals, a third chosen judge will listen to both sides at 8:45 this morning. The plaintiffs in this case went ahead and dropped Miami-Dade's mayor after a Tallahassee judge took over. Now, with a couple weeks left before many more districts begin the school year, the Florida Education Association hopes a judge sides with them to delay that process. The union doesn't believe it's safe for teachers or students. Education Commissioner Richard Corcoran sent out an emergency order saying a traditional 5-day return to brick-and-mortar schools must be included in reopening plans. But Hillsborough County defied that order, with the school board agreeing to start the first 4 weeks with distance learning. Corcoran rejected the plan, and now the district's at risk of losing $23 million. We talked with a doctor from Johns Hopkins All Children's Hospital about the outlook of sending kids to school with thousands of new COVID-19 cases added in Florida every day. Some of the best efforts from schools, like temperature checks, might be impractical.
Lack of a fever isn't all that reassuring, because we know that you can have other symptoms without a fever and still have COVID, or even no symptoms at all. But you know, if you have a school that has 1,000 students, taking 1,000 temperatures before school starts every day is really quite challenging. And for the little information that it gives you, it may not be the best use of the time.
We'll be watching this case, and you can too. We put a link to the live stream on abcactionnews.com. In Tampa, I'm Jasmine Stiles, ABC Action News.